美国最大的燃煤发电厂之一在哪里？在 Minnesota， 这是他现任的州长 Waltz 被提名为贺锦丽的副手。而贺锦丽呢，这一次在美国民主党党代表大会几乎都高举了气候变迁的议题，可是他在演说的时候他跳过去，他不想得罪石油业者、页岩油气者。那所以很多人就看到了贺锦丽他的 flexible， 他的弹性，以及他的没有原则，两个都是。所以说他称为他是一个务实的实用主义者，所以不用对他的气候变迁政策有太高的一个期待。但是他的副总统 Waltz 对他有多大的影响不知道，他个人倒是在 Minnesota 州长的任内，他就把煤炭火力发电厂原来占 52% 的电量一拉下来16%。在 Minnesota 呢，他的主要的气候转型的用电的政策重点不在去核，重点是去碳，就是去煤炭火力发电厂，然后增加了一部分的天然气，增加最多的是再生能源。所以台湾有些人在这个部分呢是反对的，就是他把一些玉米田改成种电，就是太阳能来种电。那有些人是反对的，但是我们来看一下 Minnesota 的例子。
明尼苏达州是美国最冷的州，也是 3M 总部、美国最著名的医院之一梅约医院的所在地。巴黎气候协议出炉之后，他在新任州长，也是贺锦丽的副总统候选人华兹领导下，开始能源转型。
Coal-powered plants like this one still generate nearly a fourth of Minnesota's electricity. That's down from nearly 50% in 2014. Natural gas makes up another fourth, nuclear fills in another 21%, and renewables like wind, solar, hydro, and biomass now pull the most weight at 32%, up from 21% just a decade ago. And you can see that growth on the horizon from the roof of the Sherco plant.
You can see the black panels out there.
华兹的努力确实改变了明尼苏达州这个原以农业为第二大经济生产来源的地方样貌。位于明尼亚波里斯市西北部的贝克，最能体现美国电力的过去与未来。这座拥有约5000人口的社区上空，原本矗立着全美最大的燃煤电厂之一，如今三座燃煤机组之一已经关闭。纽约时报指出，这些关闭的电厂促成了全美燃煤电力生产急剧下降。根据美国能源信息管理局的数据，到2023年年底，煤炭发电量略高于全国电力的 16%， 低于1990年的 52%。 而原本种植玉米和马铃薯的农地现在改为种电。
I'm Nathan Dahlke, and we're out at the Solar Garden by Green Isle, Minnesota, near the town where I grew up. The day in my life can vary pretty wildly. I wake up and I do chores and feed the cows and everything, and then I log on to work and I work my real job, which is in IT, and then I go out later in the afternoon and do chores again, oftentimes until the sun goes down.
A recent report puts Minnesota as a national leader in renewable energy.
Zero carbon sources generated 54% of Minnesota's power last year, remaining the majority of Minnesota's electricity for the fourth consecutive year.
These projects can be a windfall for landowners. Prairie Star Wind Farm contracted 30-year leases with 100 landowners.More than $9 million have been collectively paid out so far.
It tends to really help support local farmers in agriculture because it's, you know, agriculture has its ups and downs from the economic side of it. And when they had a lease with a wind farm, that's stable, reliable income that they get on a regular basis that they can count on.
This is how Minnesota leads.
Governor Tim Walz on Friday touted his administration's plans to curb climate change's impact on our communities. It targets 6 goals, among them setting benchmarks for clean energy and clean transportation, a sector.That's a big polluter.
To not address climate change will be that existential threat to the health, to the well-being, and to the economic future of Minnesotans for generations to come.
2019年，他上任明尼苏达州长后，立刻成立气候变迁小组内阁。2022年展开第二任期，更雷厉风行地推出气候行动框架。
It's a law. There you go. Well, today, Governor Walz signed a bill that requires utility companies provide 100% carbon-free electricity by 2040, with the goal of lowering greenhouse gas emissions and creating jobs along the way. It's a tall order, and a big part of it involves creating alternative energy facilities where fossil fuel plants have been retired.
为了落实到2050年实现净零排放、100%干净能源的目标，2023年，华资一口气签署了40项有关气候行动的法案。为了加速清洁能源项目落地，今年6月，他推动两党通过了明尼苏达州能源基础建设许可法案。美国能源媒体指出，该法案可成为全美典范。
One step closer to the state's goal of transitioning to clean energy.
Modernizing how we permit these projects, how we get that steel in the ground faster.
Officials say this new law will cut red tape for businesses starting clean energy projects, which would streamline the energy permitting process.
Politico 认为华资领导的明尼苏达州已成为拜登降低通膨法案的展示范例。
Minnesota is seeing the impact of the Inflation Reduction Act.Electric vehicle registrations saw a big boost in 2023, up 50% from a year earlier. For the first time, hydrogen production put Minnesota on the map. Electrolyzer shipments from Cummins contributed to a dramatic uptick in domestic hydrogen project announcements.
根据 Politico 截至6月11号的公告分析，明尼苏达州迄今已直接获得4.1亿美元的 IRA 联邦资助。虽然落后于加州、纽约州和德州等人口大州以及工业州如密西根州，不过该州还有望获得至少2亿美元的额外 IRA 资金，用于减少农业对气候的影响。
The difference between me putting solar arrays in their field and generating electricity and them growing corn and selling that corn to an ethanol plant that then burns it and turns it into electricity is the same thing, and they can appreciate that. For farmers, it's reallyabout being productive and doing good, and this is still in that category for them.
关闭燃煤电厂固然会带来阵痛，也不乏有怀疑论者质疑太阳能农场可能会用化学物质损害土壤，以及这种可再生能源的供电稳定性。但大多数贝克居民都接受了能源的未来在这里扎根的现实。
What used to be on this land?
This was pretty much a hayfield for my bison.
Now, 22 acres of Ed Eichton's farm is solar panels, enough to create energy for 800 homes for a year.
They work on Sundays, weekends, holidays. Doesn't matter. They work. It doesn't matter if it's cloudy or rainy or snowing. The sun rays still come through. They hit the panels and produce electricity.
纽约时报认为，贝克这座小镇不仅代表了华资政府的部分遗产，也测试了如何在全美范围内开展能源转型。
There's usually about a 10% savings on electricity costs.
Right now, 1% of Minnesota's energy comes from solar, and about half that is from the state's 131 solar gardens, which in most cases lease the land from farmers like Ed.
At my age in the mid-60s, it's kind of a, helps my retirement plan a little bit. It's a feel-good thing too, you know?
Yeah.
华资在州长任内为实现净零转型所做的种种努力与共和党的川普万斯形成了极大的对比。前美国副总统高尔称华资是一位公认的气候领导者。纽约时报认为，华资若入主白宫，将在国家应对全球暖化的关键时刻带来他的气候能力。
在全球暖化之下，北极融冰呢，几乎是它的气温上升是全球地球的三倍，而95%在30年以后都已经缩小了。地球科学家正在当地进行覆冰的技术。谢谢你收看今天文倩的世界周报，文倩的世界财经周报，我们下礼拜见，拜拜。